I got a negative test result. So today, I'm gonna show you how I got ready for this trip during the K-1 visa process and the COVID-19 pandemic. So let's get started. This trip was totally different from the other trips that I had before because of my visa process. So I was not sure if I was gonna make it. And I expected some different situations, like if I passed immigration or if I couldn't pass immigration, something like that. Then I made little rules for this trip. Number one, pack fewer things. Number two, get a COVID-19 test result just the day before your flight. Number three, prepare the documents as many as you can. Number four, practice the immigration interview. So I'm gonna describe those things to you. Number one, pack fewer things. If you couldn't pass the immigration, then you might fly back to your country right away. So I thought packing fewer things is gonna help me mentally, because I can imagine how I feel miserable if I really have to come back with all heavy luggages after long flight. Number two, get a COVID-19 test result just the day before your flight. If you were refused entry into the US, then you will fly back to your country, which means your test result should be valid when you're on the way back to your country. Each country has different rules for entries, so I recommend that you make a schedule for testing after due consideration of time limit. Number three, prepare the documents as many as you can. The CBP officer might doubt you, like you're gonna stay in the US longer than 90 days and get married illegally. So you should bring many documents with you and prove that you have to go back to your country. I made a video which is describing about those documents what I prepared, so please check it out. Number four, practice the immigration interview. The CBP officer will ask you many questions at the immigration, so you can practice answering the questions, and please try to answer the questions as honestly and simply as you can. I also made a video about the interview at the immigration, so if you have time, please check it out too. Why did I take those risks? And why didn't I just wait to get a visa? It's just simple. I was missing him. 1 year and 3 months of long distance relationship in this crazy pandemic. And we had no idea how long we have to wait and how long we have to be apart more. But I got a big chance. May 31st, 2021 was the end of the contract period of my job. So I got much time to try in this pandemic. And I didn't want to regret before I try anything. And I thought I could feel much better to try and do my best, even if I failed. Everyone has different situations, so maybe this idea is not gonna fit you. But I really pray for all of you a good luck, and I wish you can be together with your partner very soon. Thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video soon.